you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
They are not ready for primetime.
Primetime.
That's the name.
Primetime.
What time is it?
Showtime primetime.
It's XL Primetime, featuring Joe C.
I reduced my toilet paper down to 3 squares.
Matt Hayes.
Big asses and big thighs, yeah.
And Leon Searcy.
Bringing you love, peace, and soul.
How you like me now?
Oh, yeah. You go to several sites that cover the National Football League and you see teal and black. You see Josh Allen, and he's got to have a big old smile right now as he got paid. Welcome in, XL Primetime, as we are ready to crank it out. 2 to 4 this afternoon, and we're probably going to talk a bunch of Jaguars. We'll sneak some other stuff in, but it's mainly about J.A. It's mainly about a guy that you knew had produced last year and was waiting for that contract, and then a series of events unfolded, which we will probably go through and recount. But let's just get the initial reaction to Josh Allen getting a big old deal. Leon, you were on social on X earlier and certainly congratulated Josh Allen and also that feeling inside the locker room of one of your own.
Yeah, I mean, I tweeted when I initially saw Josh Allen go through the ticker on the TV, the first thing that my impression was the shockwave that is in the locker room. Basically, if you show up and you show out, you get paid.
Yeah.
And he bet on himself. He bet on black and he won. And, he didn't – the organization felt that the numbers that they were trying to get, you know, at the beginning of the season were a little too high. Josh said, okay, fine, I'm going to show you. I'm going to go out here and get it done. And he got it done, 17 and a half sacks, and he got paid. That's how it's supposed to work. That's how it's supposed to happen. And I'm proud of the Jaguars because they had developed a reputation for not feeding their own. Mm-hmm. I always say feed family first. It's always good to set a table and a chair and a place for other people to come in your home and eat, but it's always important that the guys that you draft, guys that you developed, and came along this way, and show out the way they did to pay them the contract they deserve. So the verdict is out on Tyson Campbell and Cisco now. You know they're going to their last year in their deal. They know what they need to do to get paid now. You go out there and you put up the numbers. You'll get rewarded.
$30 million a year, Matty.
And Walker Little, for that matter.
Yeah. Walker Little as well.
Exactly. Because there's a lot of those big deals that have to take place. All right, let's tie these two things. Actually, I'll tie those two things together, but first thoughts on him getting it.
I think there was no way they were getting off that $30 million number. There's no way. I think the one thing they were probably haggling about was the guaranteed money. There's no doubt about that. He was getting that $30 million money, the $30 million number, I mean. Not just becomes how many years can he make it? I mean, how many years of that contract is fulfilled? At what point do they start restructuring? It's all that same stuff that we have with every player that signs a big deal. And now our question now is, how do you live up to that contract? Mm-hmm. And that's, as you know, is going to be our poll question today, and I'll let you deliver that. But that's the big question, is how does he perform under that contract? And as important for fans is, what are your expectations of Josh Allen now with that contract? What number is going to make you say, okay, he's worth that $30 million?
Yeah, and it's funny because this is what we said, sirs, and I felt strongly about it. And everyone was railing on Trent Baalke. And look, I have had my criticisms on Trent. And the idea that they don't negotiate during the season I think is just – short-sighted. I think they should be doing that. If you have earned it and you're playing well during the season, you need to be discussing future numbers. But anyway, they didn't do that, and then he got clobbered for not having any conversation.
Well, here's the thing. As a player, you can appreciate – you want to get paid. You want to get your money. You want to do whatever you can before the start of the season get done. But the last thing you want to do is have any ill will towards your organization while they're negotiating during the season. You know what I mean about ill will? Because you're playing for this franchise. And you're speaking with your agent, and your agent is telling you things like, because, you know, the negotiating process can be very, very, I ain't going to say misleading. I'm just saying
strenuous.
Strenuous. Thank you. That word right there. It can take its toll on you.
Acrimonious.
As a player.
You
because
throwing these at you?
You can take a toll on you. He's a writer. You know, he's showing off now. He can take his tone on you as a player if you're hearing from your agent that the organization is saying some ill will towards you, and you're out there performing. So
that's a good point.
You could take it both ways. I just know that when I was in a situation with the Steelers, and Drew was my agent at a particular time, I told Drew, hey, listen, they don't want to pay me at the beginning of the season, I'll make them pay at the end.
Uh-huh. And that's, you know, the thing is, and this is actually a great point by Leon, and Joe, we saw this in the last week and a half with Josh Allen. The subtle little retweet.
Yeah. Tweet. That was an interesting one.
Right. So, I mean.
A like.
He clearly, was not happy with what was going on. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, that's, I don't know if that pushed him into quicker, making the deal quicker.
No.
The reality is this was all about the guaranteed money. But still, if you've got an unhappy guy who's one of your top two guys on your in your franchise, mm-hmm. You got to do whatever you can to make
it. It's so funny because we're sitting here and we have clobbered, and other people have clobbered Trent for saying, hey, why aren't you talking to Josh Allen in his camp? Why aren't you getting this conversation going? Because whenever they had that State of the Union address from the general manager after the season, they had not had any of those formal talks, and that's when everybody went after the general manager. And I totally get it. But at the same time, you make a good point. You don't want to get inside your head the numbers over your play. Mm-hmm. That is an excellent point. But when you do – think about this. There have been so few Jacksonville Jaguars that have been worthy of a contract discussion like Josh Allen has in recent history. And we can go back and we can see how few have gotten second contracts. It is it's terrible what this franchise has done with high draft picks and not resigning.
Listen, there was one in particular I was sure that's more than deserving of them. I knew that when Jalen Ramsey was here – I said that he's going to win $100 million, but I say he's not going to get it here. He's not going to get it with this franchise. And I don't know why, but, you know, there was tension between the two, the organization and Jalen and all in the armored truck with the money and all that other kind of flamboyant stuff that came along with it. But I said to myself, Jalen Ramsey is more than deserving of $100 million, but he won't get it here in Jacksonville.
Yeah.
And he had to go somewhere else and get it. So that's the only guy I can really think of. Over maybe the last, half a decade or so.
Look at the two different negotiation tactics, by the way.
I'm just saying.
Josh Allen doesn't say a word on Twitter and likes one thing since December, okay? Jalen shows up in a truck, a Brinks truck.
Brinks truck with money flying out of it.
And look, if you're a player, you're looking for money, you're going to do whatever you can to get their attention.
Exactly. I guess, man. Yeah. That's a little over the top.
It is. Of course it is. And then we all know that, and it was so funny because I'll never forget Jalen at one of the mandatory mini camps before he left. He said, I'm not going to get a contract in the offseason, but I'm cool with it. He sounded so mature and poised and all this stuff. This was after the Brinks truck, of course. And you're thinking, all right, this guy's growing up a little bit. He understands it. And then the Jalen plan went into full effect after that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and then he was on his way out. But if you go back in time, and we went over this before, and there's nobody left but a very few that have seen this football team make it to two playoff seasons. Cam Robinson, all the way back in 2017, was a draft pick that year. He and DeJuan Smoot are the only two guys that were able to stick around from 17 on and see multiple playoff seasons. After that, you could throw Logan Cook in there. Apologies to the punter, but you had two from 17. You had one from 2018, and that's Logan Cook. And then you had Josh Allen the following year. Nobody else is left on this football team. That is a miserable number. It really, really is to see that few that have seen this football team over a considerable amount of time where they've gotten second contracts. It's ridiculous. So few have been able to get it. So I'm happy for Josh Allen. All right, so let's set up our X poll because I'm going to give you some numbers as far as what he's got. But on X, RJ, read it out because you can get the fans involved and they can just click on X, search at 1010XL and get a vote in.
Absolutely. Our XL Prime Time X poll question brought to you by Beaver Toyota and Beaver Chevrolet. Now that Josh Allen has gotten paid, how many sacks do you believe he'll have next season? Do you believe he'll top last year's total? Maybe get somewhere in the teens, have between 6 to 10 sacks, or is he just going to lay in the shade and have less than 6 sacks? That's on X right now at 1010XL.
All right, jump in there. Give us your thought. You can, of course, hit the text line 641-1010, designed by Lifetime Enclosures, and let us know what you're thinking there. You can go to YouTube, search 1010XL, throw a comment up there as far as Josh Allen, because we need to get to the other part of this as far as the other guys getting contracts. But here are the numbers, all right? The reporting coming from all the NFL guys that are on the beat. Signing bonus, $32 million. 24 base salary, $2 million, fully guaranteed. You move on, 2024 offseason workout bonus, $500,000. 46-man roster bonus in 24, $500,000. Base salary in 2025, $32 million, fully guaranteed. Offseason workout, another $500,000. roster make the team, another half mil. 2026, $22 million is the base salary. $10.5 million is fully guaranteed. So that's kind of how we got to that $88
million. So wait a minute, they pay you $500,000 to show up to camp to work out?
You better believe it. You better believe it.
What a whirl.
But it is kind of a way that they break it out to where they can make it a base salary and kind of put some of these other numbers in a different category. So that's kind of that contract structuring.
Yeah.
But the essence of it is that you're basically looking at $88 million that would carry you through 24, 25, and 26. The 26 base salary is $22 million. That's 10.5 fully guaranteed. So that's basically two full years, and then you go into 26 with at least a little bit of a question mark. If the dude's still delivering, then you're figuring out a way to give him some more cash, or you're looking at cutting the cord.
Here's the you're going to love this too, Leon. Here's the particulars of the contract that might make Leon throw up in his mouth a little bit, okay? Well, the first one is actually very difficult. He only reaches the entire $150 million if he has 17 and a half sacks or more every year and is a Pro Bowler or All-Pro every season, all right?
Mm-hmm.
The additional bonuses, you ready for this? He gets $500,000 per year for the offseason workout, $250,000 for 12.5 sacks, Leon. So in other words, you're paying him
to produce.
To produce.
By the number.
So you're paying him already his contract and all that guaranteed money. Then you're going to pay him more if he does what you're paying him for. Okay?
You got to love
that. So then you're paying him $500,000 for 14 sacks, an additional $750,000 for 17 and a half sacks, and $1 million for a Pro Bowl or All-Pro year. Think about that. So you're already paying him.
It's laden with incentive basis.
I do think that keeps.
Right, but you're already paying him.
You're paying him even more to do his job.
Right, to do his job. Yeah, correct. Yeah.
But you know the going rate. You have to get to the going rate. Yeah. And so when it all breaks down, and this is Florio putting this out, if you do the numbers, $76.5 million fully guaranteed at the signing, $11.5 million becomes fully guaranteed in March of 26. So here we are, April of 24. You got two more seasons. And I guess in some ways you keep the cat hungry for some of this stuff, but then the other part that Matt's saying is, wait a minute, you're already paying me, and now you're going to pay me to do what you just paid me to do. But yeah, you have to, that's the world we are in, dollars wise. Just take a look.
I get that. I don't mind the offseason workout bonus either, because I would definitely, I'm okay with paying him to show up and be part of the team and be part of every workout because he's a leader. You need him there. But this stuff is, if you hit 12 and a half sacks, you get $250,000. You got to be kidding me.
What
am I paying you for?
I just feel like they've got, in other words, you were either going to pay a larger amount per season or you were going to do it this way. This is just structuring, because you're going to have to pay $30 million and beyond for your top pass rusher. That's just where it's at. That's the cycle that we're in.
All right, the lead of the league, yes.
So, yeah, so you could shape it contractually any way you want. I think what you're most interested in is how much is guaranteed.
Yeah, he got a lot of guaranteed money. Here's the unfortunate thing for him, or the fortunate thing for him. I mean, everyone's talking about, can he live up to the billing? Will the money taking its effect on him? He's not the guy that he once was. I mean, I had that same situation when I came here to Jacksonville. You know, I had to live up to my contract, but I was looked at as a whole, because if Mark played well, if Jimmy played well, all that. You know, then we all look
because
good.
Because you, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And then,
yeah.
So we all look good. Now, you know, when Josh Allen steps foot on that field, everybody's going to be looking at him, and he's going to be evaluating not only wins and losses with the Jaguars, but with him personally.
Mano a mano. Yeah.
So we're going to be looking. I mean, this big contract is going to have, he's going to be under the microscope.
And here's what I fear. What I fear is they gave him this big deal, and they wasted his career year last year. Because I don't know that he ever hit 17 and a half again. That's a big number.
Guys,
a big number.
Well,
so you could easily argue they wasted his career year last year by not getting the playoffs.
Yeah, I know we can argue that, but at the same time, he was on that defense that even though he was doing work, there were so many other guys that weren't doing. You know what he is?
No, that's what I'm saying.
Oh yeah,
by not helping him out.
We
kept saying you got to have more pass rushers.
Yeah, I totally get it that you could basically, like, you could say Trevor Lawrence had a wasted year. You could say Josh had a wasted year because they didn't get to where they wanted to go. The wasted year for Trevor was a lot worse than the wasted year last year, I guess, is the way I'm looking at it.
Right, but all I'm saying is he's the guy on the defensive side of the ball, and he produced at a high level.
Yeah.
You had nothing else around him that was producing at a high level.
If you look
that's on
the,
you.
Entire team.
You being the team, the franchise.
Yeah. Entire team not named or not numbered 41 or 44. It's like a dozen sacks. It's embarrassing. Embarrassing how few the rest of the football team got compared to those two.
And Trayvon got hot late.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was struggling early.
Yeah, first half of the season was struggling.
I'll follow your theme, Matt, and we'll come off of the natty the other night. You know what Josh Allen was on defense? He was the Zach Edey of the Jaguars defense. That's what he was. He was the guy basically doing as much as he possibly could, looking around going, hey, a little help, please.
They lose and he gets 37 and 10. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. I mean, just honestly, we looked at the numbers the other night for Zach Edey and how many few free throws or shots the other guys made or even took. It was ridiculous. He scored, basically 50% of their points the other night. And Josh has been extremely central in anything that the Jaguars have done defensively. And you can go back the last couple of years that's gone on. All right, so let me compare this. This is where I like. Let's do the 10-10 take with this, RJ, and then we'll start to get some of the reaction off the text line.
Now, Josie's 10-10 take. Slow smoked and served up by Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmaster since 68.
I like to tell you, recipes are tried and true, and once you got a good one, you don't deviate from it. And that's what they do at Sonny's. They know what they're doing. Ribs, chicken, pork, turkey, and honestly, the recipes for the baked beans, the garlic bread, whatever sides that you order, they're all tremendous. Check out any one of your area Sonny's on the First Coast. So what would you rather have? A $150 million deal that looks like Josh Allen getting an average of $30 million if he were to see this whole bad boy play out, $88 million guaranteed after he had 17 and a half sacks last year, or the New York Football Giants giving Brian Burns 5 years, $14.1 million with $87.5 million guaranteed, including a $25 million signing bonus. Let me give you the numbers real quick. We're talking 17 and a half for what Josh Allen was able to do compared to 8 for Brian Burns. You take a look at total tackles, 43 for Josh Allen, 32 for Brian Burns, 23 assists, about 5, 6, 7 less than that for Brian Burns. You take a look at quarterback pressures. We know what Josh Allen was able to do. Bottom line is, this is a good signing here, more of a question mark signing up in New York for Brian Burns, and that was a guy they had to go get from outside of their locker room and pay him. That's the 10-10 take. Real quick thought on that.
Yeah, Brian Burns' numbers were definitely, staggering over the last couple of years or whatever. Josh Allen absolutely, completely, outperformed him. But his contract, Brian Burns' contract, actually lit the flame because initially we thought Josh Allen with his numbers, we was like, hey, he can't get paid more than Bosa. Bosa is a perennial All-Pro, so he's got to think a little less. And then Brian Burns goes and makes $30 million. He was like, oh, the ante has been lifted.
Remember what we said?
Yes.
Every day that goes by.
That was Carolina with that dumb money is what that was.
Yeah. Yeah, but the Giants are the one who paid him this one.
The Giants,
yeah,
not Carolina.
Yeah, and so, but I looked at Leon when I said it. I said, everyone's freaking out. Pay the guy. He earned it. Don't let him go through the offseason, all this stuff. Every single day he was making money.
Mm-hmm. Burns is a pretty good player, too. It's not like Burns isn't a good player, but he didn't have the season, clearly.
Yeah, he didn't have the
season. He had 8 sacks last year, 12 and a half in 22, a couple of 9 sack seasons.
Yeah,
good, but not great. Good, but not $30 million good. Yeah,
right.
No doubt.
And so that's kind of where you're at. $88 million guaranteed here if he gets to see that March 2026, that last little bit of it. 87 and a half for Brian Burns. All right, you guys jump in. We'll get into it. The question was asked by you guys as far as the next guy, Cisco, Campbell. What do they have to do to get paid? And of course, Trevor is still out there. And does this money that he's getting paid actually help with the salary cap? Let's explain that coming up as far as what the Jaguars still might be able to do if they were to try and make a play for a wide receiver. That's all coming up. A golf club of Southampton Wednesday, and I can guarantee you this. Last couple of weeks, we were challenged with the weather, but the golf gods, they love the 9 after 5, and we are ready to rock and roll this afternoon. 287-PLAY. Call the golf club of Southampton. Would love to see you a little after 5 this afternoon. Tee it up with Joe C.
Cruising with XL Primetime in the First Coast Honda Dealer Studios on 1010XL. Now, a Masters update on 1010XL, brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emmerich. From winning the green jacket in April to joining LIV Golf in December for a reported $350 million, everything changed for John Rahm last year. Now Rahm is ready to defend his Masters title, and just being back at Augusta National has brought back the flood of memories.
In my case, last year being Sevi's birthday, Easter, and all the many coincidences that happened to happen on that Sunday, is what made it so special. I think the one memory that I keep remembering, you know, obviously all the family moments at the end were great, but I still have a picture where I'm holding my son and I'm giving a hug to my dad. And, you know, my son's in between us. And just to see that moment of me and my dad and having my son there was quite special.
Yeah, Rahm trying to become the first man to repeat as Masters champion since Tiger Woods in 2001 and 2002. He tees off at 10:30 a.m. Eastern, but thunderstorms are in the forecast tomorrow morning. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
Now your ideas don't have to wait. Now they have everything they need to come to life. Dell Technologies and Intel are creating technology that loves ideas. Loves expanding your business, evolving your passions. We push what technology can do, so great ideas can happen right now. Find out how to bring your ideas to life at Dell.com. Welcome to now.
For the ones who work hard to ensure their crew can always go the extra mile, and the ones who get in early so everyone can go home on time, there's Grainger. Offering professional-grade supplies backed by product experts so you can quickly and easily find what you need. Plus, you can count on access to a committed team ready to go the extra mile for you. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
The Par 3 contest is once again delivering thrills and smiles to the patrons. Let's check the leaderboard, sponsored by Dell. Dell Technologies pushes what technology can do so your great ideas can happen right now. Learn more at Dell.com. Ricky Fowler, one of the first to tee off today. He birdies 5 of the 9 holes. He's in the lead at 5 under. Austin Eckroat, Gary Woodland, and Sepp Straka all at 2 under, 3 back. Eckroat is done for the day. Woodland firing a hole-in-1 at number 6. Woodland, the 2019 U.S. Open champion, is 7 months removed from surgery to remove a tumor from his brain. Woodland now playing the 9th, the final hole. And Bubba Watson's daughter, Dakota, one of his caddies today, she has showed off her touch with long putts at 3 separate holes. Watson's even par 27 won't count since he didn't hit every shot. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emmerich, Westwood One Sports.
Hey, it's Matt Hayes. Spring is blooming, and that means your to-do list just got longer. But don't stress, everyone. The good folks at Fenwick Home Services have you covered 24/7 with cooling and plumbing solutions to fit any budget. From minor upgrades to major repairs, whatever problem you're staring down, the pros at Fenwick will get it done and get it done right the first time. Let me say that again, the first time. Spring is also a great time to reschedule your AC tune-up to avoid costly breakdowns. Fenwick certified technicians will inspect your system to make sure it runs efficiently and remove dust buildup, pollen, and dander so you can breathe easier. Book now at FenwickHomeServices.com/radio. That's FenwickHomeServices.com/radio.
Why live with foot or ankle pain? If you have persistent pain, numbness, tingling, burning pain on the bottom of your foot, or swelling that doesn't improve with home treatment, it may be time to see Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute. Our foot and ankle specialists have innovative new options to help you get back in the swing of things without persistent pain that slows you down. Call JOI 2000 or go to joionline.net for an appointment.
Our slogan, Know Before You Blow, applies to more than just DUI cases. Hi, I'm attorney Lee Lockett of Lockett Law. Battery charges can result in jail time and criminal convictions too, so know before you blow a gasket and hit a loved one or a stranger. Drug crimes like possession of marijuana and cocaine will land you in cuffs too, so know before you blow. In a boating under the influence case, you also have the option to blow or not to blow. So know your options. Know before you blow. Go to knowbeforeyoublow.com now. Office is Jacksonville.
Any adventure, any task, any time. There's a CF Moto Utility ATV or UTV for any rider. See the full lineup at Ride Now Beach Boulevard. Venture seekers can start with the trail-tested capability and comfort of the Z-Force lineup. For the ultimate in UTV performance, check out the Z-Force 950. Find your utility ATV at Ride Now Beach Boulevard or online at cfmotousa.com. ATVs are recommended for the use only by riders age 16 years and older. ATVs can be hazardous to operate. CF Moto recommends approved training course for safety and training information.
Looking to make a great impression? Dylan Denmark here, folks, and when I want to score big, I send flowers or a plant from Jacksonville's best, Kuhn Flowers. Yeah, man, it's always a good thing to send someone a Kuhn floral arrangement. KuhnFlowers.com.
All right, guys, be a true grill master with the Sausage Dudes sausage and upgrade that cookout. The Sausage Dudes are guys from Jacksonville who use their family recipes to make better sausage with the best cuts of pork, carefully sourced spices, and natural casings. And the Sausage Dudes are mission-minded, supporting the Boys and Girls Club of Northeast Florida. Try all four flavors because your cookout deserves better. Now available at all Publix stores in the frozen meat section. Head to Publix today and get your hands on the Sausage Dudes sausage.
A tradition unlike any other.
Rays Creek, Butler Cabin, and the Green Jacket.
Ready to rip it.
The Masters.
That's a beauty.
Masters coverage on 1010XL is brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, presented by FIS, is home all week at 1-1 Financial Ballpark. Tomorrow is Coors Light Thirsty Thursday with beer specials, then it's Red Shirt Friday with fireworks, and the first 2,000 fans on Saturday get free Jumbo Shrimp pajama pants, plus more fireworks. Baseball all weekend with tickets starting at just $5. Log on to jackshrimp.com for tickets. Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, affordable family fun.
This is Hayes Carline for First Florida Credit Union. I bank with First Florida Credit Union because I trust them. I can always count on them when it comes to the vast services they provide. First Florida Credit Union was voted Best Bank in the 2023 Best of Bold City Community Choice Awards, and it's easy to see why. I go to the branch off 210 in St. Johns County and the new Durbin location, but they have 10 branches in the Jacksonville area. You need to be banking with First Florida Credit Union. They're enriching people every day. Federally insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Opportunity Lender.
Prosser here for Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. With the weather starting to turn for the better, look ahead. Get that backyard ready for spring with a new screened-in enclosure. Maximize the space you have and make it great with Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. They truly are best in the business. If you have the space and the idea, give them a call today. Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. Showroom just off Phillips Highway. Tell them Prosser sent you. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Yo, this is Tony from Tony D's. Are you looking for a great slice of pizza? Well, we have about 12 varieties. Most places won't have slices of pizza after lunch. At Tony D's, you can get a slice all day. It's always fresh at Tony D's Pizza. Bay Meadows and 295.
Golf takes center stage at Hidden Hills Golf Club, but we have a little bit of something for everyone. So whether you want to practice, play, or just relax with friends in the Hills Grill, Hidden Hills is a place for you. Visit us at HiddenHillsGC.com.
Hey guys, Hicken here. It's April. Spring has sprung. It's a great time to get that house painted for the summer. Stop paying for exterior paint that doesn't protect your home or business. Rhino Shield's beautifully durable coatings never chip, crack, or peel. 25-year warranty to back that up. No mold, mildew, and algae. Water intrusion? Forget about it. Fight salt corrosion has a Class A fire rating. All while saving you thousands. Right now, 0% financing. New low pricing up to 25% off. Book your free estimate today at RhinoShieldJax.com.
For the greenest, luscious lawn on the block, choose the local legends, Roundtree Sod. Don't just settle for ordinary. Let Roundtree Sod deliver you a picture-perfect lawn. To get a free estimate, call 7414-SOD. 7414-SOD.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. This is XL Primetime. Brought to you by Florida Home AC. Now that's cool on 1010XL.
I love when people get all fired up about what we say on XL Primetime. And by the way, we're floating opinions. That's what we love doing. Joe C, Matt Hayes, Big Searce, RJ cranking it right now. But off the text line, OMG, Jalen Ramsey compared to Josh Allen, please. Jalen fakes an injury, quits on his team, goes somewhere else, and everywhere he's been, they've been glad to get rid of him because he's a cancer in the locker room, yada, yada, yada. Josh is a team leader. by no means did we ever.
We were just making fun of Jalen.
Yes, we were making fun of Jalen.
Yeah, we're talking about this team figuring out when they're going to pay their players, their ones that deserve to stay here. And guess what? They made a calculated decision that Jalen wasn't necessarily the guy that they wanted to put a big pile of money in front of.
But let's not forget now, before the antics, in which Jalen Ramsey, he was more than deserving of a huge contract.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
And the reason why there was dissension in the locker room is because when y'all gave that, I say y'all, gave Blake Bortles that money, that defense was like, what the hell? He didn't help us win the game. I mean, their defense was locked and loaded.
It was defense and run game. Now,
absolutely.
Bortles had two great
He did against the Steelers. He absolutely did.
But, yeah, the other two got them
It didn't merit $80 million, $89 million.
What you're saying is there were sides in that locker room.
Of course there were. There was ascension. Yes, of course. When they gave him $89 million, they were like, what the hell is going on here?
All right, now we got a few off the text line that we need to get to, including one that says Burns is better. Oh, yeah, okay. You must be a Giants fan. Or
maybe go root for Burns. Yeah. We're gonna root for Josh and the Jags here. How about that?
Yeah, plenty of people congratulating Josh Allen, so we'll try and get to those. But let's get to this other question real quick. The idea that that next guy in line is who? Cisco, Little, Campbell. Of course, Trevor, you'd have to consider, is at the top of the board and probably the legit next guy in line. But that doesn't mean these other guys don't need to step up.
Well, these other guys, they have incentives. And like I said before, the reputation of the Jaguars was that when they draft guys and they develop guys, they don't pay guys. Well, this Josh Allen thing just throws that out the window. Josh Allen proved, and the Jaguars, he showed, and they proved, and they paid him. So that's the key. So if you're Cisco or you're Tyson Campbell, you look on the board, who are the elite DBs or safety that are making a certain amount of money,
right?
And your level of expectation or your level of play should – either exceed that or be near that if you want to get the kind of money that you're going to ask for.
Yeah, because they're not signing any of those three guys.
Exactly. Unless
none of them are getting
unless
signed.
They're barn burners.
I mean, before this season.
Oh, no, not before the season. No, I mean, they're going to have to show and prove. They're going to have to bet on themselves this season before the Jaguars.
You know, like Devon Hamilton's deal last year. Nothing like that's going to happen any of those three.
No.
I mean, I'd be shocked if it did, but I would think those guys are not getting paid before this season.
They're all on approve it.
Yeah, approve it.
And Walker Little's at the top of the list on approve it because he has been moved around. At the very least, Tyson Campbell's been through injury, but he's had that spot.
He's on approve it. He's kind of on approve it too, man.
I'm not saying he's not. I'm just saying Walker's at the top of that list.
But guess who the benefactor of all this is? The Jaguars. Yeah. They're going to be the benefactors. If you got Tyson Campbell, you got Cisco, and you got Walker Little, and you're saying, hey, listen, I got to see it first.
Yeah.
You know, if they ball out – the Jaguars benefit from it.
And by the way, ETN's on a little bit of a prove it, too.
Yeah.
Because you got to figure out where you are going with the running back position. And they'll pick up, I'm guessing, they're obviously picking up Trevor's fifth-year option. They're picking up.
Yeah.
Trevor's
on a prove it, too. I wouldn't pay Trevor this year.
I don't think ETN's on a prove it. I think he's on a show them they can't be without you. Like, he's done enough to get a second contract, but it's the position that
the
hurts.
Position does not.
But if he has like a 1,400-yard season or a 1,300-yard season, they're not letting him go.
But let's not forget this. This is where they have to basically take a look at that second first-round pick and basically sign in this third offseason that they're going to pick up their fifth-year option.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And so that's basically what they've got to decide on. You know they're doing it for Trevor. Now they got to decide to do it. As far as ETN is concerned. All right, so we'll keep it rolling with that. Dr. Barry, pop it in here in just a second. We've got Masters talk. Man, I got to get some of those picks out. You guys let us know who you like at Augusta. If you're laying down some wagers, you're putting some odds on a guy, let me know. 641-1010. Hit the text line because I'm putting that little pimento cheese Masters pool together later. And I need some intel. Bring it.
Riding in the First Coast Honda Dealer Studios. XL Primetime on 1010XL.
What's that?
Find 1010XL on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram by searching 1010XL. And follow the conversation on social media because listening at the dinner table would be rude.
Oh boy, the Masters is here, Tiger is in the field, and the Live guys are back at the majors again. Mia here, and if you haven't signed up for MyBookie, you need to sign up this week. This is going to be must-see TV, and you can bet long odds for big golf sweats and even bigger cash. Outright winners, first-round leaders, live betting too. I'm telling you, if you haven't signed up yet for MyBookie, do it for Masters Week. Could the weather in Augusta cause some chaos? Take advantage of that. Make some money. Even if the Masters has started, you can still live bet with long odds through Sunday afternoon. Getting started is simple. Sign up today at MyBookie and use promo code 1010XL to secure a first deposit bonus up to 50%. It's simple. Just use promo code 1010XL to claim your 50% bonus, $50 minimum. This is one of the most fun betting weeks of the year, and you can hit winners for long odds. Promo code 1010XL. Bet with MyBookie.
Do you have clicking, popping, swelling, or pain in your knee or shoulder? This can be due to arthritic changes in your joints. Over time, you have wear and tear of your cartilage. I am Dr. George Bari, and here at Bari Orthopedics, we have numerous ways to treat your arthritis, such as regenerative medicine, including PRP, and joint replacements with CT guidance for accuracy down to the millimeter. If you are experiencing any of these symptoms, call us for an appointment today, or log on to BariOrthopedics.com.
Find out more at BariOrthopedics.com. That's B-A-H-R-I Orthopedics.com.
Jacksonville, the ultimate rock experience big engine, is storming into Players Grill Mandarin, known for electric performances at NASCAR events nationwide. Join the big engine freaks Friday, April 12th at 8 p.m. Players Grill, where the neighborhood meets.
Divorce, menonly.com. This is Kenny Lay of Kenny Lay & Associates. Our firm specializes in representing men in family law. That's all we do. That's our only focus. We can help with all of your family law needs, such as divorce, custody, alimony, and child support. For over a decade, we have helped thousands of men with these types of issues. We even have an appellate division ready to challenge a judge's ruling. If you need a family law attorney, go to divorcemenonly.com. Divorcemenonly.com. Offices, Jacksonville.
You don't have to be a football star to get a signing bonus. The team at Republic Services needs your skills, and they're paying up to $5,000 for you to join the roster. You'll be joining a winner. As an essential business, the Republic Services trucks have not stopped rolling with hourly and weekly pay and better benefits and vacation packages than the rest of the league. Driver trainees, $1,000 sign-on bonus. CDL drivers, $3,000. Diesel mechanics, $5,000 bonus. Join the winning team at Republic Services today. Visit Republic Services.
Equal opportunity employer.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 10th, 1947, Jackie Robinson becomes the first African-American player of the 20th century to sign an MLB contract. The Dodgers bought Robinson's contract from the Montreal Royals.
It's Kubota Orange Days, your golden chance to score a deal that will make your neighbors green with envy. Shop the year's best selection of Kubota tractors, zero-turn mowers, and utility vehicles, including the number one selling compact tractor in the USA. And get the year's best deals, like 0% APR for 84 months or up to $3,300 off L3302 tractors. Coastal Equipment on New Kings Road and in McClenny. Coastal
Equipment. Breaking news, Jacksonville. Play It Again Sports is back. We are proud to be opening a brand new store on Merrill Road, but we need your help. We are currently stocking up and we need your gently used sports and fitness equipment. Play It Again Sports offers cash on the spot for all your used gear. We buy baseball, softball, football, hockey, lacrosse, golf, water sports. You name it, we buy it. Turn that gear into cash at Play It Again Sports Jacksonville on Merrill Road near 295 in the Merrill Station Shopping Plaza.
Mia here. Looking to spruce up your home or business for the spring? Window Gang's exterior cleaning services will remove stubborn stains, restore windows to a clear shine, and ensure your gutters flow freely. Call 262-7300 for a free estimate.
Doc Doc Rooter is a full-service plumbing company that's locally owned and operated, fully licensed and insured. We'll be at your home in a timely manner, provide honest pricing, and ensure the job is completed correctly, or we'll make it right. Doc Doc Rooter can handle all plumbing jobs, including repairing broken pipes, clearing clogged drains, to installing new fixtures, water heaters, garbage disposals, and full repipes for older homes. If you're stuck, call the Doc, 904-862-6769. That's 904-862-6769.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Our next guest is not affiliated with the NFL or Jacksonville Jaguars.
Discussion of injuries is solely based on opinion.
Now, the Bari Orthopedics and Sports Medicine Injury Breakdown.
I'm coming in hot.
The music means the man has entered the building, Dr. George Barry. Gio, what is up, Gio?
What's up, man?
Listen, man, I'm fired up and ready to go. It's Augusta week, so I'm going to ask you about Tiger Woods. And I don't know that he's fired up with the injury that he has, but we're going to talk golf. We talk sports injuries. He is fellowship trained under the renowned Dr. James Andrews, Dr. George Barry. You can find him at BarryOrthopedics.com with locations all over the city of Jacksonville. Now, if you got a sports injury question, 641-1010. Hit us with whatever your aches and pain is. I got a couple left over from last week, Gio, that we want to hit.
Okay.
But I figured I would ask about Tiger. And we were talking about it in pre-show. I want Tiger to be around on Sunday. Who doesn't, okay, if you're a golf fan? Who doesn't? He's chasing his sixth green jacket. Bottom line is he's played 26 holes this year. That's it. He played 18 one day. Then after that, he was gone the next day, okay, and basically said he had flu-like symptoms, so he didn't have an injury.
Right.
But getting back in a wet, long, hilly golf course, what are we looking at with everything he's been through?
I mean, it's going to be tough. He's played almost as many holes as I've played, and I haven't played anything. So it's going to be really tough, I think, to go back and you know, try to win. I know you're mentioning he wants to get another one. But mm-hmm. with his history and since his injury, he was declining in age, which is normal, and then mm-hmm. he had his back issues, and then he had that disaster of an injury that he's lucky to still have his leg. And then since then, I think the downhill has gone a little quicker than normal. And I don't think, you know, he's going to have his good days, but overall, I don't think he's going to be there to be able to win. You know, hopefully he does, but
he said his body
is at this point.
Said his body hurts every single day. I was joking right. with Matt yesterday. Like, you see, he looks like the Incredible Hulk. He does.
He does. But he says he literally, the quote was, "I ache every day."
Yeah.
So, is it a, as I'm staring at your Twix iced coffee, I cannot believe that you drink Twix iced coffee, Gio. It's just amazing. Twix iced coffee in Vienna fingers.
Yeah, he's going to be jacked up when he gets back in the operating room.
I'm like,
look out, Luke Cherry. Look out.
So, I wonder if Tiger eats those Vienna sausages things, you know? So, he says he hurts every day. So the wives' tale of when it rains, it hurts more. Is that real?
It's real.
Really?
The barometric pressure changes the joint, the pressure in the joint, and it is real. It's scientifically proven. It's not like my old grandparents just say that and they're crazy. It is a real thing.
Right. And I'm going to tell your beautiful wife that you're eating those Vienna sausages, mm-hmm. by the way. She's not going to be happy.
All right. Let's just weave this one golf question in, and then we got to bring up Michael Penix, who is another one of the draft guys that we're going to bring up as far as he's got significant injuries. Bottom line is, from the text line, one of our XL primetimers, he texted in, "Saturday, I took a golf swing, felt like an electric shock in my lower back, down the left side.
Oh, boy.
To the bottom of my calf, down the left side, to the bottom of my calf, was in a ton of pain all day Saturday, couldn't sit, only lay down. Went to urgent care Sunday. They said they think sciatic nerve and gave me a steroid shot. Still not great, but improving. How long should I wait to start? Trying to do sciatic nerve stretches?"
So immediately, you could start doing that immediately. It's not going to be a problem. Definitely sounds like a nerve, especially with golf, all the twisting motion and the pain going down your leg. Definitely sounds like a nerve got pinched somewhere. And you can start that rehab and those movements immediately, as long as pain allows you to, right? If you're severely in pain, it's going to be tough. But now that the pain has calmed down with the steroid shot, mm-hmm. you can definitely try to do that.
All right, what's the best stretch for a sciatic?
Oh, man, that's a good question. I mean, you know, people say sciatic is a very encompassing diagnosis, quote-unquote.
Right.
Like, 'cause a lot of people say, oh, my sciatic. But, you know, stretching your glutes is big because you can get pinching in you get what we call piriformis syndrome. People will call it sciatic. And you stretch your glutes, you stretch your piriformis. Stretching your back and getting more mobility is big.
Whenever I tell them, kiss my piriformis, that's what I'm talking about.
Stretching your hamstrings is also important. People forget, they don't understand. But your hamstrings, if you stretch that out, changes your posture and how you walk. So those three things I would say are key. And there's a lot of stuff you can find online on how to do what stretches.
All right, let's move on to Michael Penix, who's probably the number six rated quarterback of this year's draft class. Expected to go in the second, late third, somewhere around there, anywhere second, third, okay? Has a history of injuries, and that's what a lot of people are saying is holding him back and driving his draft grade down, including ACL surgeries, reconstructions on the same knee.
Twice.
twice.
Right. Yeah.
Now, you were saying earlier, prior to the show we were talking, the percentage rate of re-injuring now has increased.
Yeah.
Explain that.
Well, so when I went to that team physicians course, they were talking about ACL tears at the combine, and their studies at the NFL now show that any NFL player or any college player that has an ACL tear
at any position,
they said overall,
okay,
right? They got torn and had a reconstruction. And when he shows up to the combine and he gets in the NFL, within 20 months, 25% of them will have a tear, a re-tear.
One out of four.
That's what they were saying at the course, yeah.
Okay, so
within
here,
20 months.
Here are the numbers. 2018, he suffered an ACL. 2020, same right knee ACL. 2019, shoulder clavicle fracture. 2021, AC joint separation.
Yeah.
A lot of stuff.
He is a walking mass unit, but what
but
worries
to
you?
To be fair, the last 2 years he's been completely healthy.
Yeah. Yeah. And the other thing, Matt,
and he's played at a high level.
Exactly. And I was trying to think of the number. I have to look this number up. I believe he's only been sacked 30 times since the last year at Indiana and then the 2 years at Washington. That means he's been able to protect his body.
Yeah.
The biggest worry for me, not the AC joint, not the clavicle, it's the ACL.
Right.
Okay. That is going to be the biggest thing that teams are going to take a chance on, because if he's going to re-injure something, it's the ACL, right? I mean, that's just statistically.
That's a huge number. One out of every four does it again in 20 months.
That's what they were saying.
So if you're looking at him, just specifically him, he's gone now more than 24 months.
Right.
More than that, the last injury was 2020, right, Joe?
Yeah,
2020. So he's gone almost 4 years without redoing it.
Right.
So you would think he's not part of that one of four then, right?
You know, there's a couple variables to that. One, is he not running, is he not as mobile anymore because he's at two, so he doesn't take as many risks and not running out of the pocket? I'm sure he's not as mobile
as he used. He definitely doesn't do
that.
So that
would decrease your chance, right? The less you run, the less chance you have of getting that force and getting hit and whatnot. And then, you know, that doesn't mean he's going to tear it just because he had two, but the studies show that there's a high chance you're going to tear. Now, what they'll do is they'll get an MRI on him. They'll look at the graft, make sure it's intact. They'll look at where the drill holes were, make sure it was anatomic, because if it's not, then there's a higher chance of re-tear, et cetera. I mean, there's a bunch of variables. They'll do all that testing first, I'm sure, to make sure that what they're going to pay for is not going to get injured and be a waste.
All right, Dr. George Barr, you got a sports injury question, 641-1010. We will try and include it on Breaking Bones if we miss it here. Let me show you the one that I do have from last week, Gio. This is the bursa sack. And so our dude, all he did was text in. He shot a picture of himself with the bursa sack problem. He said, best thing for bursa sack?
So lecanon bursitis, your lecanon is the tip of your elbow. You have a little bursa sack there. Sometimes it gets big. You don't have to do anything for it if it doesn't bother you. If it bothers you because you put your elbow down, that's the most likely reason people come in, because when they put their elbow down, it hurts. Or it can look ugly when it gets really big. But what we do, you could try anti-inflammatories in a compression brace or ace wrap. And if it's really big, you can aspirate. You come to the clinic, we stick a needle in it, pull the fluid out, inject some cortisone, reduce that inflammation. Hopefully it doesn't come back. It can come back. And on recurrent lecanon bursitis that do keep coming back after aspiration, you just take it out. And then the bursa grows back, and there's a small chance it can still get swollen, but usually it doesn't.
You make that sound so easy. We're just going to aspirate it with a needle. Well, it's all good.
Listen, this is standard. This is SOP for him, standard operating procedure. You can handle this, right?
I think so.
Now, the radio doctor, my diagnosis would be, instead of 16-ounce curls, bridge it back to 12-ounce curls. That would be my diagnosis.
Right.
All right, we're out of here. If they miss any of our Breaking Bones show,
Apple, Google, Spotify, 1010XL.
Yeah, go check them out anywhere. Of course, Dr. George Barr, he's full of information. Thank you, Gio.
Thanks, guys.
All right, we keep it rolling. Let's get Big Search back in here.
Bro, I mean, two ACLs, and then you have a 25% chance of having it happen again 20 months later. That's unthinkable.
It is, very and much so.
Speaking of unthinkable, you finally watched
Unthinkable last night.
Wait a minute.
He didn't even want you to respond to Michael Penix.
No.
He wanted to get
to Unthinkable. We're getting right into Unthinkable.
Yeah, I mean, listen, Matt Hayes is a very sick man. I mean, you're a sick man. You really are.
Why?
You've been asking me for months to watch this movie. I watched the movie, all right? The movie is a combination of Saw meets Die Hard. Okay, that's the movie.
I love Die Hard.
Come on.
Bro, it's terrible.
It's great. It's got the intense like Die Hard.
It is intense, man, but it's gruesome, bro. Have an empty stomach when you eat.
Come on.
It's that bad, man.
Here's the best part. After he texted us and said, I can't believe you made me watch that movie, Campo texted me like 30 seconds later and said, what was the name of that movie again? I'm going to watch it. So I told him. He hasn't written back yet. I texted him about an hour ago. Did you watch Unthinkable? He hasn't written back, so he might be in the same boat, Leon.
I'm so glad that Searcy was the sacrificial lamb and watching Unthinkable. Now I don't have to worry about it. All right, into the 3 o'clock hour, we hope that we will be able to carry the presser, Jaguars.com, with Josh Allen being introduced as the newest guy to get a contract. He's been part of your Jacksonville Jaguars for quite some time, since 2019. So we'll have him up with our radio portion of our show. You can also stream it at Jaguars.com.
The First Coast Honda Dealer Studios on 1010XL. Now, a Masters update on 1010XL, brought to you by Vaughn Motor Group.
From the Augusta National Golf Club, Westwood One Sports presents this special report on the Masters. I'm Ted Emmerich. Wyndham Clark is aware of the history. After the first Masters tournament in 1934, the only player to win his first Masters start is Fuzzy Zeller in 1979. Clark taking it all in this week as he prepares for tomorrow's first round.
You know, I've always dreamt about this place, and I've watched pretty much every Masters since I was, probably 5 years old. So to finally be here and to experience it in person is pretty spectacular. And, yeah, it's living up to the hype. So I'm really hoping that, I bring my game this week and really get to enjoy everything that Augusta National and the Masters Tournament has to offer.
Now, Clark would seem better positioned than most Masters rookies. He's ranked fourth in the world after winning 3 times in the last year, including the U.S. Open at Los Angeles Country Club. Clark is scheduled to tee off at 10:54 a.m. Eastern. Keyword scheduled, because heavy rain is in the forecast. You're listening to coverage of the 2024 Masters on Westwood One.
Doors take us to summers away or winter adventures and afternoon getaways. Your dedicated Fidelity advisor can help you open those doors by working with you on a comprehensive plan to help you reach your wealth's full potential. Because doors were meant to be opened. Visit fidelity.com/wealth. Investment minimum supply. Fidelity Brokerage Services, LLC, member NYSE, SIPC.
Without the ones like you who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Grayson Murray's fiance, Christiana, might be a ringer at the par 3 contest at Augusta National. She poured in a tricky downhill putt on one hole, stuck her approach at another to within 10 feet. Murray shot a 3 over, but his score won't count. Let's check the leaderboard, sponsored by Fidelity Wealth Management. Ricky Fowler on top at 5 under in the par 3, score of 22 today. Neil Shipley, the runner-up at the U.S. Amateur last year at Cherry Hills, is 3 under through 5. That's 2 back of Fowler. 3 holes in 1 so far today. Luke List and Gary Woodland both spinning one in at number 6. Sepp Straka dropped an ace at number 5. So Straka is at 2 under now through 7. Austin Eckroat, 2 under as well. Again, 3 back of Fowler. From Augusta, I'm Ted Emmerich, Westwood One Sports.
At Honda, we appreciate all the comparisons to other vehicles. And no matter how many times they compare their vehicles to a Honda, only a Honda is a Honda. Remember, value, quality, safety. There is no substitute. Visit your local Honda dealer now and experience the difference.
David Lane here again for Southeast Orthopedic Specialist. After several surgeries for age-old issues, mainly my back and shoulders, there's no doubt that Southeast Orthopedic Specialist is my sustaining resource for living pain-free. Take it from me, and I'm being really honest here, there's no better orthopedic facility here in Jacksonville.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialist.
WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
What spelled funny but smells great? A Kuhn Flowers floral arrangement. Kuhn Flowers. The name is synonymous with excellence for over 75 years. High Flying Jacko here for your next floral purchase. Call on Kuhn Flowers.
Bring your marketing to the next level with 3D Digital, your local video production and digital marketing agency that specializes in ensuring your brand's story is seen, heard, and remembered. Our award-winning team creates professional content that will be launched across multiple platforms to precisely target your audience. Call us at 904-712-4004 or visit 3ddigital.com to define, design, and deliver exceptional results for your business.
Attention real estate agents, loan officers, and mortgage professionals. Trust your real estate closings to the expertise of St. John's Title, LLC. As a board-certified attorney-owned and operated firm with years of experience, St. John's Title provides the utmost of precision and professionalism. With conveniently located offices and in-home remote closing options, our customer-first approach ensures a seamless process tailored to your timeline. Join our team of experts and five-star testimonials from customers across the First Coast. Choose St. John's Title.
The 2024 draft is almost here.
The Jaguars are now on the clock.
Join us at Everbank Stadium Thursday, April 25th for the official draft party presented by Donovan Air Electric and Plumbing. Be there as the Jaguars make the 17th overall pick, and don't miss the unveiling of the official 30th season logo that you voted on. We're getting the party started at 7 p.m. Tickets are free, so register today at jaguars.com/draft party. We can't wait to see you there.
The Jacksonville Jaguars select...
This is your Southeast Orthopedic Specialist local sports update. I'm Andrew Gibson for 1010XL. The big news of the day, the Jaguars and Josh Allen have agreed to a five-year, $150 million contract. According to ESPN's Adam Schefter, the deal includes $88 million guaranteed. Jeff Prosser from The Drill with his reaction this morning.
Very few first-round draft picks in Jaguars history, especially since 2000, have earned it. We know. And here's a guy who has done every single thing you've asked of him. Everything. He's been a good teammate. He's been a captain. He's been great in the community. He plays hard. He works on his craft. And he produces. Right. Dude had 17 and a half sacks, man.
It's 82 degrees at 3 o'clock. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. This is XL Primetime, brought to you by Florida Home AC. Now that's cool on 1010XL.
Big doings in Duval. We're going to take you right down to the bank, a golf club of Southampton Wednesday with Joe C., Maddie. Big Sirs, but we want you to hear the Jaguars.com coverage of the Josh Allen presser. When we go, you'll be able to hear it on the radio, but you will not be able to hear it on the apps. But you certainly can go to Jaguars.com and listen there. But we want all of Duval to be able to hear it. Here's the presser.
My guys. Josh, could you talk a little bit about the timing?